Hello and welcome to Metaphorically Speaking with me, Delia Dolor, the podcast where we dissect popular mottos, mantras and metaphors, tracing their origins and finding how they translate to everyday life. Each week we have a special guest who resonates with their chosen expression. This week's metaphor was a very hard metaphor to actually put into context because not many people could actually relate to it without having to really think long and hard as to really it did make any sense to them. Stay with us and you'll understand more why I would say something like this. Today, we'll be exploring the positive mindset we should all strive to reach for, a phrase that our guest Felicia Persaud will be joining us for. Things are working out for me. That's the metaphor that we'll be discussing today. So let's dive into it.
It's not the critic who counts. It's not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles or where the doer of deeds could have done it better. The credit belongs to the person who's actually in the arena, whose face is marred with blood and sweat and dust, who at the best, in the end, knows the triumph of high achievement, and who at worst, if he fails, he fails daring greatly.
We will all face hardships in our lives, and it's going to be frustrating, but that's just part of what life can offer. Reaching your goals and feeling this sense of accomplishment is often a long and hard road filled with mistakes, ups and downs, and maybe the want to give in and give up. But there is, as another phrase goes, light at the end of the tunnel. If we learn from our mistakes, if we push forward and don't let the failures force us to be stagnant or go backwards, we may reach the point where we can say, things are working out for me.
It's Monday, the 23rd of January, 2017.
My name is Tom, I'm 24, and I'm a failure. I'm failing as a father, and I'm currently failing as a human being. Now, I'm not making this video for attention or sympathy or to feel sorry for myself. I just want to share the point in life I'm at, how I got here, and hopefully to the point where I'm going to be.
Look at YouTube star Tom Stockdale, for example. Very recently, Tom announced he was quitting YouTube as, since starting his account 5 years ago, he has achieved his goals and overcome the hardships he faced all those years ago. His channel and his story was called Diary of a Failure, as that is what his life at the time was. He was jobless, penniless, barely just off the street, and was in thousands of pounds of debt. He was miserable and didn't know what else to do. So he began to document his journey. He showed the highs and lows of his life for 5 years. Audiences watched as he found work, lost work, found love, gained success, lost it for a moment and found it again. He is now nearly debt-free, has become a better father, is successful in his career and feels that he has found true happiness for himself. There are ups and downs that may still happen, but at this stage, we can infer that things are working out for Tom.
So like I said at the start of this video, you know, if you're going through something, or you know someone that is, send them this video. It's not the end. 5 years' time, everything's changed. I love where I live. I love my life. I love my job. I love my friends. Everything's amazing. Now, that's not to say there's still not down days, right? Happiness isn't a constant state of being, but I'm content. I'm way more happy than I am sad. Now, there's some days, obviously, I'll wake up and just feel a bit grim, but I power through them.
Looking at success stories isn't always helpful. In some cases, the overnight successes of those who reached stardom from humble beginnings aren't always true and aren't always achievable. Everyone is different and every journey is different, but in pushing forward, we can find ways to overcome. It might take time. You might even fall further and get into a stage of the worst experiences. But eventually, one day, your chances may change. One day, you might be able to say that things are working out for me. Let's get some encouragement so we can say things are always working out for me. Here's Ella Fitzgerald with Things Are Looking Up.
If I should suddenly start to sing or stand on my head or anything, don't think that I've lost my senses. It's just that my happiness finally commences. The long, long ages of dull despair are turning into thin air. And it seems that suddenly I've become the happiest girl alive. Things are looking up. I've been looking the landscape over, and it's covered with four-leaf clover. Oh, things are looking up since love looked up at me. Bitter was my cup, but no more will I be the mourner, for I've certainly turned the corner. Oh, things are looking up since love looked up at me. See the sunbeams, everyone beams just because of you. Love's in session and my depression is unmistakably through. Things are looking up. It's a great little world we live in. Oh, I'm happy as a pup since love looked up at me. Everyone beams just because of you. Love's in session and my depression is unmistakably through. Things are looking up. It's a great little world we live in. Oh, I'm happy as a pup since love looked up at me.
Felicia J. Persaud is a Black Caribbean-born immigrant who has risen from an undocumented immigrant to a US citizen, journalist, and entrepreneur. Felicia is also a columnist and advocate for the Caribbean American community in the US and the Caribbean. Felicia, thank you so much for joining us on Metaphorically Speaking. Your metaphor is so interesting, and I think many people would say they will have a hard time actually resonating with it. Your metaphor is, things are always working out for me. That is something that most of us would love you could say. Why did you choose that metaphor?
Well, you know, Delia, it's a very interesting how I came upon it. And I actually have to credit Abraham Hicks, because she is the teacher of that principle. And really, I was going through a very, very hard time a couple of years ago. And I was really in a very dark place. And, you know, many people think that, you know, when they look on the outside, they think, oh, you're so successful. And they have no idea what is going on behind the scenes and how hard it can be. You know, being an entrepreneur and being a small business owner and really going at this on your own. And I was at a place where I had lost a major client. And this was actually pre-COVID. So this was 2019. It was coming down almost to the end of the year. I had lost a major client. I did not know how we were going to make it or how we were going to stay afloat in 2020. And I was really at a very dark place. I was crying a lot. I was pretty much getting into a depression. And I started getting into pretty much mindfulness and meditation and, you know, following Deepak Chopra and all of the gurus out there. But one of the most major teachers that resonated with me was Abraham Hicks. And really, this is mainly what she teaches her students, is that things are always working out for you. No matter how difficult it seems, if you look at the end like a script writer does, they write the scene and they shoot the scene at the end. The director shoots the end scene before they even start the movie. So if you look at the end and understand that no matter how difficult it is, that things are always working out for you, and you soothe yourself with that mantra just over and over again, things are always working out for me, things are always working out for me. And then you really are able to start getting into a place of calm and peace, and then understanding that if things are always working out for me, then there is no need to stress and worry. And soon your energy starts going up and you start again attracting in the positive things. And so that is really the principle in this. When you're down, you attract things that are negative. When you're up and you're positive and you know that things are always working out for you, that is what you start attracting into your life, and you start building up that energy, and more momentum will attract, as the universe does. The law of attraction is you attract what you put out and it comes back to you.
I have never heard it put in that way. And I am amazed, because like you, when I'm going through difficult times or anxious moments, I turn to meditation, I look at, you know, breathing practices and all those kind of things. And in those instances, they always say to you to tell yourself things like, I am safe, I am in the present, everything's going to be all right. That's a kind of trail of thought they put you on. But I've never heard the things are always working out for you principle. But the way that you've said it has really made me think differently. And it's making me think of similar metaphors which don't use the same word. So things like every dog has its day. That's what I use when I'm down, or when someone else is a bit down and they say, oh well, and they complain, oh, I tried that and it didn't work, and blah blah blah. So I think it's really amazing.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, and then really, if you think about it, you know, there is also the biblical principle that says, you know, no matter what you're going through, if you keep faith, you basically, it will work out. Things are always working for good. That's what the Bible says. And if it's not good right now, then it's not over. And so it's really the same principle. It's, you know, things are always working out, no matter. And if you think back, if you really study this, you know, literally for a second, and you look back at some of the darkest places in your life, or some of the hardest things that you've gone through, I have had so many hard things to deal with, but I wasn't crying and down and all depressed and, you know, be acting all, you know, pretty much mad and angry and all of these negative emotions. You know, they've obviously worked out, because here you are, you know, you're here today, you're present, you're alive, you know, you woke up this morning, you're healthy. I'm so much in a better place. And trust me, even during the pandemic, because of this journey that I entered, it wasn't as difficult. I wasn't even fazed by the pandemic. I was absolutely fine, at peace, you know, doing my meditations, going to the gym, doing my work, you know, going through it, and knowing every time that I think about something and I think, oh my goodness, I don't know how this is going to end, I go back to my mantra. Oh no, things are always working out for me. Things are always working out for me. Even though sometimes it looks like it's not working out for me, it is always working out for me. And that's really how you soothe yourself and bring yourself back to this place of peace and joy and energy. And that's really where you need, you know, to keep your energy up, because you don't want to get, you know, if you start crying, then you're going to attract more things to cry about. And that's really not how we want to live our lives.
I love that positivity. And as you're speaking again, I thought of another metaphor that could work perhaps side by side. And that one is, every disappointment is a blessing.
Yep.
What do you think of that? If I had to say to you, what do you think of that as a metaphor in terms of working side by side with, things are always working out for me, every disappointment is a blessing?
You know, Delia, I was so reminded of that this week, because this week has been one of those weeks where I never anticipated having to deal with this whole issue that we had this week, which was the governments of the Caribbean, the government-backed agency, actually taking our name in West Caribbean and using it. And really, we've had to fight all week to enforce our trademark and really go back and forth. So it has been one of those weeks where I have realized that, just like you say, things that you think are negative at the time, it's actually a lesson. It's all, everything works in as a lesson for us moving along the path of life. So if we don't go through these rainstorms or these, you know, what we call, sometimes we say, oh, they're bad things happening to me. They're not really bad things. They're just hard lessons. Having to deal with this teaches me how to be a better leader, how to be a better CEO. And that is really something that I found so absolutely necessary in all of the conflict. Here was the real gem or the rainbow in the rainstorm. And that is really what we have to look at life as.
Tell us more about your business and, of course, CaribPR.
We have actually four brands, and our whole group is called ICN Group. And we have four brands, CaribPR Wire, which is the PR newswire of the Caribbean, and also a partner of CISN, which is the major PR newswire in the world. We also own News Americas, which we run as our daily Caribbean and Latin American newswire. And we essentially are a one-stop shop if you're looking for news from the Caribbean or Latin America, as well as from the diaspora here in the U.S., it's News Americas. And we also own two other brands, Heartbeat Communications, which is our digital PR and ad agency. And then we own Invest Caribbean, which I referenced earlier, which was what we had to enforce our trademark with, which is really an investment agency. So we basically are connecting people who want to invest in the Caribbean, who want to raise money, who want to do business there. Basically, we're connecting them as the conduit to the region, you know, from overseas or wherever they are in the world. And that's really, you know, our four brands, and they work pretty much together in a way. But also they have their own distinct identity, obviously, and it just takes a whole lot to keep them all together under one roof and keep them going.
Well, now I know why it was so difficult to pin you down to talk to, because, of course, everything that you're saying there, it's not a 9-to-5, it's more like a 24/7. So
exactly.
I know that you've got...
Exactly.
Yes. So you have a lot going on there, but how did it first start with your very first business? How did that start?
Well, you know, Delia, I was a journalist for many years. You know, I came to the U.S. I actually came here to do a conference at the U.N. And at the time, my aunt was having a lot of personal issues. And I ended up staying, which meant that I had overstayed my visa. So eventually, I became an undocumented immigrant in this country. But that did not stop me. I was still, you know, working as a journalist and doing my thing and just pretty much hustling like most immigrants do. And essentially, I got sponsored for my green card by a Caribbean organization. But that took a number of years in order for me to get it. So in the meantime, obviously, I had to survive. And so I had to come up with a way to essentially launch my own business. And so while I was doing freelancing and work for companies as an independent contractor, I was essentially also now thinking of how do I set this up on my own. And as news was the background, the news arm is what actually came first. So I launched my own newswire. It was at the time the only daily newswire here in the diaspora. And from that, then it came to me that we needed a PR newswire for the Caribbean, since we didn't have anything that did that. And that's how the CaribPR part came about. And then we were very lucky to be able to partner with CISN very early on. We got a contract with them. And then from there, clients start asking us, well, we need you to do ad buys. We need you to do these other things that a PR agency or an ad agency would do. So that's how Heartbeat Communications was birthed. And we pretty much started doing that. Now, Invest Caribbean pretty much came very later on. It was in 2011, and it just came by accident because I was having a chat with the CEO at the time of the Caribbean Tourism Organization in New York, and they always had a Caribbean Week in New York, essentially. And I said to her, why is there no investment portion of your Caribbean Week in New York? And so essentially she said, oh, do you want to do it? And I was like, me, I don't really know much about investments or anything like that. And she's like, yeah, you can do it. And so that's really how we were thrown in. And so we pretty much came up with the name Invest Caribbean, because that was our message to investors on Wall Street and everybody that were coming in to this first breakfast that we had at the Marriott in New York. And so that's really the genesis of Invest Caribbean, and really a whole lot of work and a whole long way since, you know, we've pretty much pivoted our business strategy a number of times, from our conferences to now just essentially working with private individuals who are looking to raise money or invest in the Caribbean. And that's really, you know, the genesis of my evolution, as I would say, you know, into business.
Well, it's been really exciting talking to you, and I truly admire all the things that you have done, because as you said, it didn't just come overnight, and it was not an easy thing. You had obstacles in your way, and you have achieved something that is so worthwhile and needed, especially when it comes to the Caribbean and the news coming out of the Caribbean. Being part of the Caribbean framework, I'm very exposed to the news that is happening there and the bigger picture. So it's nice to actually see, when you're coming from the US, drawing the news that pertains to the Caribbean and sharing it in a different way, in a different angle, and which can be used within the Caribbean and, of course, internationally. It's really nice to see it in that angle. So where can our listeners find you online?
Well, absolutely. So we're at newsamericasnow.com. That's our news part. CaribPR.com, which is obviously our CaribPR newswire. Heartbeatcommunications.com, now our digital PR agency. And of course, InvestCaribbeanNow.com is our investment agency into the Caribbean. So they can find us anywhere on that, on those websites, or they can also go on ICNGroup.VIP, and we're all, everything that I just mentioned is linked right there, ICNGroup.VIP.
Felicia, thank you so much for joining us today, and all the best with your adventures. And of course, you just continue to grow, and I'll be watching you.
Thank you so much, Delia. Always my pleasure.
After listening to Felicia, I had to hear what Abraham Hicks said. I found an inspirational piece on YouTube called Be the Recipient of All Good Things. Listen to this while you get ready for sleep.
This is the time that I have nothing to do other than to be right here and be the recipient of all good things. Vibrationally. Cellularly. Emotionally. Energetically. This is the part of the day that I look forward to. This is the winding down part.
Many people commented on it. Lamia Sally said that great things started to happen to her when she started listening to it, and she listens to it every night. Then I thought of another speech I had listened to by Denzel Washington.
I found that nothing in life is worthwhile unless you take risks. Nothing. Nelson Mandela said, there is no passion to be found playing small and settling for a life that's less than the one you're capable of living. Fail big. You will fail at some point in your life. Accept it. You will lose. You will embarrass yourself. You will suck at something. There's no doubt about it. In the acting business, you fail all the time. Early on in my career, I auditioned for a part in a Broadway musical. Perfect role for me, I thought. So I'm in the wings, I'm about to go on stage, but the guy in front of me, he's singing like Pavarotti, and I'm just shrinking, I'm getting smaller and smaller. So they say, oh, thank you very much, and you'll be hearing from us. So I come out with my little sheet music, and so I assumed I didn't get the job. But the next part of the audition, he called me back. The next part of the audition is the acting part of the audition. So I'm like, hey, okay, maybe I can't sing, but I know I can act. So they pair me with this guy. And again, I didn't know about musical theater. And musical theater is big, so they can reach everyone all the way in the back of the stadium. And I'm more from a realistic, naturalistic kind of acting where you know, you actually talk to the person next to you. So I don't know what my line was. My line was, well, hand me the cup. And his line was, well, I will hand you the cup, my dear. The cup will be there to be handed to you. I didn't get the job. But here's the thing. I didn't quit. I didn't fall back. I walked out of there to prepare for the next audition, and the next audition, and the next audition. I prayed. I prayed. And I prayed. But I continued to fail and fail and fail. But it didn't matter, because you know what? There's an old saying, you hang around the barbershop long enough, sooner or later you're gonna get a haircut. So you will catch a break, and I did catch a break. Last year, I did a play called Fences on Broadway. Someone talked about it. Won the Tony Award. But here's the kicker. It was at the Court Theater. It was at the same theater that I failed that first audition 30 years prior.
Do you think if you listened to Denzel Washington's words that things would work out for you? In the first half, we explored how it can take a lot to reach a stage of feeling successful, but that eventually you can experience that. It may just take time. For this half, we'll be exploring what it can mean to say this phrase when you reach that stage.
Vulnerability is defined as uncertainty, risk, and emotional exposure. Can you name one act of courage that you've ever been involved in or that you've ever even witnessed that did not involve uncertainty, risk, and emotional exposure? And it's a loaded question because I know the answer is no.
That was Brené Brown. The satisfaction of reaching a goal or goals that you have set out to achieve is an incredible feeling. Whether it be paying off a debt, finally being able to earn enough that you can treat yourself, or having the chance to explore a lifelong passion, having the chance to say that things are working out for me is something many people wish to experience. Take the pandemic years, for example. We all experienced a horrific time, yet within that time, some people took the opportunity of being locked up to explore and do something they never gave themselves the chance to do before. Whether it be starting a podcast, like Metaphorically Speaking, learning a new language, exploring old loves like painting or music, or even just the chance to discover more of yourself. Whatever it may have been, having that chance to explore was often what people needed. Times were still tough, of course, but a little happiness on the side was still enough for a feeling of accomplishment. We may have been locked up and worried, but by finding some joy, there was a sense that maybe things could work out.
In the face of really hard stuff, illness, death, loss, the only thing we're begging for is a normal moment. Like, oh my God, can I please have that ordinary moment back? You know, can I please hear this him come through the screen porch door? Can I please get a call from my mom or a crazy tech? Like, then we want the ordinary moments. But in them, that ordinariness can almost be, for those of us who haven't found a way to love it in ourselves, repulsive.
When our writer Francesca thought about the phrase, things are working out for me, she struggled to think of what this could mean or how this saying could be explored. Initially, she'd struggled as to her, the phrase felt like it was bragging. She'd not heard anyone say this before and had definitely never said it before. She'd never felt like things had worked out for her, even after all she'd accomplished. But then, when thinking about it more, it got her thinking. What if it just had to be a thing?
What is that? What do you call that thing?
That's it.
The thing. Yeah, you think this is bad, you should have seen it before.
Okay.
Not everything in your life will be perfect or going well all at once. Sometimes it can just be that one thing, the thing you've been trying to accomplish for so long, that you succeed at, that could lead you to saying that things are working out for me. Maybe you managed to get your baby down to sleep with no trouble for the first time, or maybe you managed to finish your tasks for the day at work and got to finish early. Whatever it is, no matter how big or small, you've accomplished it. You've beaten it. You have things working out for you, even if these things are just one. One thing going right and celebrating that can lead to a second and a third. And maybe one day you can look back and see all that you have accomplished and truly believe that, yes, things are working out for me. Isn't that a great way to think about things?
I think we're all kind of ordinary people. I get to do extraordinary things, but I think we're all ordinary people. But I think sometimes this world is tough because we shame and diminish ordinary. Ordinary lives are small lives. Mm-hmm. You know, ordinary moments are, you know, we chase extraordinary moments instead of like being grateful for ordinary moments until hard shit happens.
Things are working out for me is something many of us may think we'll never reach the stage of. There will always be something that gets in the way. There will always be something stopping us from that satisfaction. But even if it is just one thing that you can succeed at, you have the right to say that things are working out for me. You never know, just hearing those words may help you reach that next goal. Before I go, I'd like to leave you with this song, and I'm hoping that things will work out for you. It's by Bob Marley, Three Little Birds.
Thank you.
I hope you've enjoyed this episode of Metaphorically Speaking. I know that it made me realize that I have accomplished many things that I could say things are always working out for me. Although, right at the beginning, I thought, how can I really say that with all honesty? I guess, as our writer Francesca said, it's more about thinking about maybe that one thing and the accumulation of many one things that makes the things are always working out for me work in general. What do you think? Thank you to our guest, Felicia Persaud, for speaking with me today. And thank you, of course, always for listening. Don't forget, if you'd like to suggest a metaphor for an upcoming show, you can reach me at colorful.com/shows/Delia and use the contact tab or email info@metaphorically speaking.uk. Of course, we'd love you to share the show with your friends or leave a review on colorful.com. or on our podcast, Metaphorically Speaking, which is on Apple, Spotify, and all major streaming platforms. I say this all the time because it's really true. We depend on you to help us grow so we can produce the best content for you to enjoy. Join us for another metaphor next week. Until then, I'm Delia Dolor. Keep safe. Goodbye.